In this training module, we will add dual to a plastic pedestal controller, which already has a 24 conventional stations installed. The principles are the same for all configurations of dual. Before we install the dual, let's start with grounding. Inside all I-Core controllers, be it a wall mount or a plastic pedestal, they have a grounding lug. And here is your number 6 gauge ground wire leaving the controller. That's metric size 13 as well. And that needs to be connected out to an 8-foot grounding rod. Grounding is critical for the proper operation of these controllers. You want to make sure that your grounding rod as well is perpendicular to any wire path leaving the controller. It needs to be at least 8 feet away if it's an 8-foot ground rod. So here we have an example of controller grounding. We've already attached the number 6 bare copper wire back at the controller to its grounding lug. And we've ran that copper wire in smooth sweeps over here to this grounding rod. You want to make sure that you don't have any sharp 90 degree bends in that grounding wire. Always make a smooth, gentle curving sweep. Here we've attached to a 8-foot or 2.5 meter ground rod driven completely into the ground. It's very important not to skimp on this ground rod and cut a portion off and only bury in 2 or 3 feet. You'll want to bury in the entire 8 feet. The amount of earth contact that you have with your plate or your rod is indicative of the level of grounding that you'll achieve. So don't skimp on this and use the entire 8-foot rod. As well, we've got a grounding plate downstream hooked to this grounding rod. It's a 36-inch long grounding plate. That's about 1 meter, and it is buried 30 inches deep, or about 75 centimeters. And this grounding setup is perpendicular to the 2-wire path and at least 8 feet away from the controller from here out. You'll want to consult ASIC.org, which is the American Society of Irrigation Consultants, for the grounding specs that apply in your area.